In the next question, we have to obtain Nyquist rate for given signal. Now, in this signal, if we will calculate maximum frequency component in radian per second, then it will be equal to 300 pi into 2 or 600 pi radian per second. Now, in the next component, next term, the maximum frequency component omega m2, it will be equal to 4000 pi into 2. Now, in any case, if we will apply square on this signal, then maximum frequency component of signal will get doubled. So, we have used this rule here. In the first part, we did the same thing. Now, these two signals are multiplying, and if signals are multiplying, then maximum frequency component of result is given by adding the maximum frequency components of individual signals. So omega m will be equal to summation of omega m1 and omega m2. In case of multiplication, maximum frequency components of signal will be added. Now, if we will add these two terms, then it will be equal to 8600 pi radian per second. Now, to calculate Nyquist rate, we have to multiply omega m with 2. So, it will be equal to 2 into 8600 pi. Now, we have to obtain Nyquist rate in Hertz. So, we will divide omega Nyquist by 2 pi. So, it would be equal to 2 into 8600 pi divided by 2 pi. Pi will be cancelled out and 2 will be also cancelled out. So, F Nyquist will be equal to 8600 Hertz, and we can write down this term as 8.6 kilohertz. Now, if we will look at all four options, then option C will satisfy this result.